Gentlemen, come on in, come on in. I want to show you what we're going to do this afternoon. Hopefully just a small job, but let me show you real quick. Now, you all remember, this tail panel now has got to go, and it is in terrible shape, you know. I mean, I could almost zip it off there, but, it really wouldn't matter. The new tail piece that I'll show you here in a minute, there's spot welds all through here, and then down through here are actually rivets. Hopefully you can see that rivet there, spot weld, rivet, all the way down, back up, and through here. All right, let me show you the new piece.
Right there.
So, right through here, down, and through. Now, the tools that we're going to use, or I'm going to use, is that right there. That'll be the first thing. We're going to cut through those spot welds with that. But before that, I'm going to do a little grinding there. And with my pads there, then I'm going to try to use some of these here to knock through the rivets and the spot welds. So let's get with it. Come on, let's go. Change of plans. Gentlemen, let me bring you up to speed. So this is the second day of trying to get this tail panel off. And as y'all saw yesterday, the this situation here, that didn't work out very well because these spot welds and everything on this old rusty car, they just didn't want to go. So you know what I did? I figured out a better way to do it. And today, I'm gonna take care of business today with this sucker right here. So let me show you exactly what's gonna happen, hopefully in this video, and then we'll go from there. So this is where, you know, I left off yesterday here, going all the way down. And this is three levels here. The quarter panel, and also this part of the quarter panel right here. this part of the quarter panel. Here is one layer, the tail lamp, the backside, this thing here, this panel, is a second layer here, and then it comes down and folds over and right here as well. And so there's a lot going on behind this mess right here. It's all not good. So I'm gonna try to get most of this out of here like so today. I'm gonna come down here. I'm gonna attempt to take care of this. All this though is gone. All this is gone. Here is a better view of that. This lower quarter panel I purchased does also have this support on it as well. But as you can see, all that underneath, that's got to go. That's got to go. So therefore, when I get this thing off, or get it mostly off, I may have to cut down or something, I don't know. But I'm going to cut now over here today, right here. I'm just going to zip all down through here, and then this right here has got to go. So whether I get it off of here, it doesn't really matter, because these two are connected. Now my thoughts, you know, quite frankly, my idea was just leave it there and just work around that, because that is a lot of work getting that off, and then having to line it up and everything, you know, all this. But we're just gonna have to wait and see on this thing. So, you know, I mean, this is a learning curve for me, so let's get it on right now. Check this out now. Look at all this. I'm gonna have that all removed here in just a little while with the rest of that panel. And then we're gonna start the cleanup. Let me show you this. I'm gonna experiment with this today. It's that walnut. Put it in that. And then what I'm gonna try to do is see if it'll clean up all of this 50-year-old undercoating. I'm gonna experiment with that today. This is that, what I was telling you about, is that something that I'm gonna cut right here. Let me get a better picture of that. So everything is looking good. Now you can see that this area here is not that rusted here, right? So I clipped off that part there. My thinking is I may just cut across somewhere here and down, or here and in that gap there and down, and then just leave all that, maybe, unless I decide to get rid of the whole thing, because I really do not want to start fooling around with this right here. I really, really don't want to do that. So my thoughts were, I would just sort of, you know, maybe even cut like right down, well, let's see, like right down through here, and then right down through here, and then that's it. And all this will just fall away at that point. So that is what, that's what I'm going to do right now, and then I'll make a final decision. Part of the trunk floor, as you can see, that's what was holding it up right there. So I've got a new trunk floor, obviously. That'll all be replaced. So that was what was holding it up right there. Here's the rest of that trunk floor. Gotta go. Look at that. You know, or I could just cut half of it out, because that other, as it gets closer to this fold down back seat, it's not that bad. Let me show you. So my thoughts were, maybe I'll just cut out, you know, half of the trunk floor or three quarters of the trunk floor. That way I don't have to get into those wheel wells too deeply anyway. So there you go. All right, so now I've got this cleared out, I'm gonna try this walnut sand grit idea now. Let's see how that works. So the idea behind that is, this is a tub and the sand goes down in there. The little gun here, and then you just shoot it, and hopefully it takes care of all this grit and everything else. Now, I don't know if it's gonna work. If not, you know what? I bought some wire wheels today, and might do it the hard way. So let's check it out. Let's see if this is gonna work. Let's do it. All right, there's the sand. Now, I'm gonna try to spray a little piece to try it right there. All right, I do want to get a face mask though. Nah, no, didn't work that well. But I tell you what, it did put out a lot of sand. And so my thinking is we're gonna have to do it the old fashioned way. And that's with a wire wheel. So now I'm gonna check that out. Let me give you an overview of what I saw today. And it was something else. So let me, first off, right here, see that there's a lot. This is an undercoating for 50 years. Undercoating. Another code right here, interestingly. 50 years of undercoating, and I'm not sure what's going to happen here. I do not want to replace these inner fenders. You know, I really don't. So I'm going to have to make a decision on how am I going to do that. It's a bunch of stuff back in here. Let me show you what I'm looking at here. This is 50 years of undercoating here. And the sand did not work. That did not work. And I really do not want to replace these inner fenders here. Not really. The trunk drop downs, not too bad. A little bit of a rust area there. This is that area I was talking to you earlier. I did not take that out, and I trimmed off this right here. So, you know, it's just a matter of, it's right inside there. Just a matter of trimming it off a little bit more. But I was real pleased with how that turned out. Of course, the trunk floor, I got a new one of those. All of that will be replaced. 50 years of undercoating is right there. And I really don't want to replace these inner fenders here. It's just too much. The sand did not work at all, not really. It was too much. But all this, it all worked out very well. And here are those old pieces right there. And there's the new piece. So there you have it. So I will make a decision on how am I going to get this undercoating out of here. And because I'm not going to take them those inner fenders out. That's just too much. So I will work on it. I'll make a decision. And then I'll be looking for your comments. Let me know what you think. So I'll talk to you later on the Muscle Car Man's Garage.